Welcome back to Jen Beauty. My name is Jennifer, and here on my channel, I like to talk about all things beauty and makeup related. And I hope you will come along for the journey with me as I shop my stash. Initially, I was going to do this once a month, and I figured out that I'm very bored. I'm not going to make it a month. There's no way. I'm not going to do it. So my goal with Shop My Stash is just to make sure that I am giving love to the things in my collection that I may otherwise be neglecting, or to even make a final decision on things that I say I'm not sure about, I don't feel like I've tried out enough, or I have on the chopping block. For example, the foundation that I am trying out now, so far I've tried it twice and both times I'm not a fan. Like, it looks okay from far away, not in high light, but if you look up close, like, it looks so cakey. And I haven't changed anything about my skincare routine. The last time I wore makeup before today and yesterday, my makeup looked fantastic. So I'm gonna try one or two more times to make it work. And if it doesn't, I don't know if I'm going to return it or just see if someone else in my life can use it. And then I also am not sure that I like the primer that I'm using. I feel like my face is on fire, and it's happened each time I've used this primer. I've now used it with three different foundations. So I think it's the primer. I don't think it's anything else I'm doing. I'm going to take another break from it. And I'm going to try it one more time with everything that I know absolutely 100% does not bother my skin and try it again. So if I'm looking kind of a wreck today, that's part of the reason. The other part of the reason is this eye has been dripping constantly. It will not stop leaking. And then we got a water softener, so my hair should start to be like less frizzy. My hair should start to be less frizzy soon because that hard water was like killing my hair. I think it may take one more treatment at the hairdresser before it like really decides that we can go back to the way that it was supposed to be. But like, it's not holding, when I straighten it, it's not holding like the straight, even though I'm using like a nice heat protectant and everything. And I may just need to find products that I like and embrace the waviness, but I really don't want to do that because it's just my preference to keep destroying my hair. Anywho, let's talk about the products that I used last round. And I don't know what's going up first. I don't know if it's the declutter first or I don't know if the declutter will go up first or if this video will go up first, but I did a declutter. And in that, I kind of switched around a little bit of the lip products. So initially, I had all of these Tarte H2O glosses in my Shop My Stash. And in the declutter, I decided to pull these out and keep these two, but declutter the rest of them. I wasn't enjoying using them. I actually do really like the look of this one enough to get over like the very sticky feeling. And I like this one too. So these two are unique enough to me that like, I think I will still give them some love. They still smell good. Nothing's wrong with them. They are getting a little bit older, but I want to say we're at like a year maybe. So the pink one is Pink Sands, and then the purple one is Out of Office. Anyways, I do like these a lot as far as like the finish. I'm wearing one today over, it was Prince Edward. I may be able to show you my vanity and what a mess that is. I don't remember if it was Prince Edward. I think it was. I got interrupted by the alarm clock that reminds me to take my medication. So my bad. And then I think I initially only had one of these in my Shop My Stash, but they smell like they're starting to go. Like, they don't smell as sweet as they used to. And the formula is separating just a little bit. So I decided to put them all in my Shop My Stash to give them some more love. And then I ended up randomly putting this one in there. And somehow my Cinderella ended up in my Shop My Stash. So I have been showing all of these lip products some more love lately. So let's talk about them real quick. So this is the ColourPop Bullet Lipstick. It's from the Disney Designer Collection. My husband got me all of the princess ones. It came in like a whole pack. But this is the shade Cinderella. I don't know why I'm still having all of these in my left hand. This is the shade Cinderella, and I absolutely love this shade. It's very, just a delicate pink color. And then also from the Disney Designer Collection, I have all of these. These are the princes. So there's Prince Edward, Prince Naveen, Flynn, Prince Philip, and Beast. I really enjoy this formula a lot. And then I have the Queen or Queen, and this is in the shade Thick Skin, and I think it's a lip paint. I think it's on the box. I don't think it's on the tube itself. I really like it. It is a little bit more of a dry formula, so if you have extremely dry lips, it's best to use like a nice lip mask before you put it on, or with a lip gloss. So I like pairing these Tarte H2O glosses with the other stuff. Now, I don't know if they were reformulating the H2O glosses or if it was the H2O like lipsticks, like lip balm stick thingies. I forget what they're called. I don't know which ones they were formulating or discontinuing, but they're doing something with the H2Os. I know that these, like, they have some H2O glosses, but they're in different looking packaging now. So my review of these may not be helpful to you at all, since most of this stuff is not still available. Two things that are still available are the Wander Beauty Skyliner, and this is just in the shade Black. So it does have a little bit of a thicker tip to it than the ColourPop Cream Gel Liners. I'll show you the difference between the two. So ColourPop is this like burgundy mauve color, and then Wander is this red one. It's in the shade Black, but the actual tube itself is like this really deep red. So I like it. It's one that you can kind of like smudge out and smoke out, which is my preferred method for wearing eyeliner, since, for example, with something like this, if I had a wing, it would be like flying off to Canada right now, because it's just not happening with the tears that keep pouring out of my left eye. Thankfully, it's mostly dry, but I do feel it like tearing back up every now and then. So I use this quite a bit, and I don't feel like I need to keep showing it more love. I don't feel like I'm neglecting it now. And I feel like I have a good enough handle on it that I'll know when I want to use it and when I don't. And it does come with a little like sharpener at the end. So it's a retractable pencil. Is it? Yeah. So it's a retractable pencil, but if you want the tip of it to be a little bit more finer tipped, then you can use the little sharpener to sharpen it, which is something that I really wish these cream gel liners had. ColourPop. I have asked for it on their posts before about their cream gel liners, but I'm just me. They're doing just fine on their sales and nobody asked my opinion. I did a themed Shop My Stash that I made up for Snow White. And so for Evil Queen, I had picked the eyeliner. For the dwarves, I picked for Happy a highlighter. And I have to find it because for some reason, there went the hairspray. Okay, it's not in the bin that I use because I put it on my daughter's eyes. I'm an idiot because this says glitter on it. And I'm pretty sure when I bought it on the website, it also said glitter there. Did I pay attention? No, I did not. So it's not very opaque as far as the highlighter goes. It's like a cream to powder glitter. It looks a lot more like just a layer of glitter than it does really like a highlighter. And it looks kind of cool underneath the studio light that I have, but it does not look as cool in person. Like, it looks like a lot of specks of glitter on your face, or at least on me. However, my daughter really does look very good in this, using it as like a just a nice sweep of an eyeshadow. She's 8. Like, she just turned 8 this week. So I'm going to give it to her. When I did my declutter, I said I was going to declutter it once I was done with this round of Shop My Stash, and she's going. I think I used it on her more than I did me. No, that's not true. I did use it on myself. I used it as like glitter around this area, and then I did as the highlighter like twice. So I used it 3 times, made a final decision, and that's my goal for the Shop My Stash. Anywho, for Dopey, it was my matte lips. I had one matte lip. I think I chose Beast. I didn't write it down. Then for Magic Mirror, that is supposed to be something new or shiny. I'm gonna have to go back and watch my old video now to figure out why or what I was supposed to do. And then for the Huntsman, that is a chopping block item, and that was the H2O gloss, so we've already discussed that. And then for Snow White, that is something fit for a princess, so something luxurious, girly, or royal, and I chose the Disney Designer Collection ColourPop palette. Okay, let's talk about this for a minute. If you know me, you know that I don't really reach for warm tones. And this is like unassumingly a fairly warm tone palette. So the couple of looks that I did with this, I didn't fully enjoy. Like, they just were not my favorite. I do really like Prince Charming for an inner corner highlight. You can't really tell, but I did use it, I'd say like 7 or 8 times. So I've thought a lot about like if I want to declutter it or if I want to keep it. And I think I like the shimmers in this enough that I want to give it some more love. So I'm definitely going to move it out of rotation from the Shop My Stash. But I feel like I made enough of progress, you know, giving it love. To make a decision that I would like to keep it around for a little bit longer. So it's not going anywhere yet. And maybe that's the collector in me, like trying to justify keeping something, but whatever. I can collect what I want to. It's my life. So now I need to shop for new items. So I'm going to put this stuff up and come back and do some shopping with you this time instead of just talking about products. My hair is driving me crazy, if you can't tell. Like, absolutely nutty insane. It won't listen to what I tell it to. So, we'll be back. Okay. For Magic Mirror, I remembered that I actually shifted gears from my new BH Cosmetics primer and decided to use the Watermelon Burst Hydrating Primer from Ciate London. And I used it like two or three times, and each time I got like pretty bad breakouts and decided that either the formula is something that breaks me out or it's just too old. I don't think it's that old, but it says 12 months, and I think we're coming right at 12 months since the first time I used this. So it's very possible. I also noticed that these little like watermelon bursty thingies that are in here were not like massaging into the face as much as they did when I first got it. So it's my bad for not using it enough and for getting distracted by other primers before I finish this one. So I am actually decluttering this. I'm throwing this in my declutter bin, and I didn't replace it with anything other than I've been trying a bunch of different primers. So once I decided I was not going to use this anymore, I shifted gears and started using these e.l.f. ones. So it's time to shop for new products. Give me just a second and I'm going to flip you around and we'll start shopping. Okay, so this is where the magic happens. Today I did my daughter's hair and makeup for her dress rehearsal for her recital, so the makeup desk is a really big mess. So first, let me get my notes. Let's see what we want to do. I think I want to do something fit for a princess again, so something luxurious, girly, or royal. Let's show some love to my Patrick Ta blush. You can see where I swatched it for my declutter, and I love it. Like, it's a very pretty color. This is the shade She's Passionate. So let's give this one some love. I tend not to reach for it because I can't stand the packaging, but it is a beautiful blush on. So we're gonna put that in my Shop My Stash bin. And I'm actually going to leave the designer, Disney designer matte lips in here because I feel like the formula is really starting to go, and they weren't cheap. I'd like to give them as much love as I can before it's time for them to go. So those can be something tired for sleepy, so something older or well-loved. And then let's do something that brings me joy. I mean, like, this whole entire beauty room brings me joy, but let's pick a palette that brings me joy. They all do. Isn't that why we're here? You know what? Barbie. Barbie has always brought me a lot of joy. Now, I probably am gonna hate myself for this because, again, this is another like pretty warm tone palette, but I think there are enough brights in here that I can at least give some love to the shimmers. I kind of want to do a pink and yellow look. Is that crazy? That might be crazy, but I don't care. So, for happy, we have something that brings me joy. Magic mirror. Let's do something new or shiny. I mean, Patrick Ta is shiny. Is there a highlighter I want to show some love to? Yes. I want to show some love to this new Nomad highlighter. And the mirror is not glued to the palette, so I really need to glue it back on. But it really is a gorgeous highlighter. So let's show some love to that. It is both new and shiny. I have Snow White, something fit for a princess, and then I have Magic Mirror, something new or shiny, and then I have Happy, something that brings me joy, and then the lipsticks are Sleepy, something tired or older or well loved. And then let's do one more. I'm trying to think if I have a chopping block item. I don't want to put the Power Grip primer in there, even though it's like on the chopping block right now, because I want this to last longer than like using it one time. I want something that I really need to make up my mind on. Let's do, where are they? Okay, let's do these Looksee shadows again. So I was trying them out and they were not in this last round of Shop My Stash, but I did talk about them in my ranking. And I'd like to keep trying them out. So these are on the chopping block. They swatch so beautifully, but they just seem to like disappear on my lids. So I'd like to give them some more love and keep trying them out with different eye primers and see what's up, if I can get them to work. So let this be your lesson, not to spend $100, even though you get like 50 shadows, because it may not be worth it. Those are the three shades I just swatched. So I should have more to report in on Looksee later. All right, so that'll wrap it up for today. We're gonna do the outro more vlog style. I like the Shop My Stash videos because they're a little bit quicker of a video, but you still get some reviews and you still get to see some collection. And with me, you get to see the very real mess that is my beauty room. Sometimes it's clean and sometimes it's not very beautiful. I hope that you enjoyed today's video. If you liked it, please go ahead and give it a big thumbs up. I really appreciate you joining me today. And if you'd like to see more makeup and beauty content from me, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and I'll have more makeup and beauty content coming at you. I hope wherever you are, you have a beautiful and wonderful day. Bye. No idea if you can hear my kids, but I'm assuming that we can, so I'm waiting.